Greetings, Benjamin J. the Victrola Guy with another in the series. Again, the S10 shaver. I've moved it to the floor, and you'll notice the Ziploc bag has got a bunch of swarf in it, but there is not one speck of swarf anyplace else. It's all going into that bag. So in any case, this is the S10 shaver, and I wanted to do a video on a speed control for it. Now, the S10 shaver is of course, set up as a dictaphone shaver. It's for shaving full-size dictation cylinders. And this thing is just screaming when it is running, which is great if you're going to be shaving dictation cylinders, if you're going to be shaving other cylinders, like original black wax recording blanks, and especially brown wax recording blanks. You cannot run the shaver at this speed. The RPM is so high that the wax cylinders, will just blow apart, literally. They'll just come apart like a $2 suitcase. So, what you do is you go down to Home Depot and you get a light dimmer. And this is one of those dimmers that has a cord and you plug it into the wall, and then what you're going to dim plugs into its plug. And it gives you a complete speed control for your cylinder shaver. So we're running at full speed. Watch this. And the nice thing about this thing is if you're going to be shaving brown wax cylinders, you can set the speed and forget it. And then when you turn the machine off, next time you turn it back on, it'll be set for shaving brown wax cylinders. And it won't run any faster than that. And you can set it for any speed you want it to run at, of course. I found about 3/4 speed works best for general shaving of black wax recording blanks. And it's still more than fast enough shaving cylinder, but it makes a tremendous difference. And as I said, brown wax cylinders, you simply cannot shave them with the shaver running at full speed. It'll destroy them. So just a quick video on a really effective speed control for your shaver, whatever kind it may be. And I've used these for lots of projects. In fact, these are outstanding if you have a Dremel tool. If you don't have a multi-speed Dremel tool and you got one speed on, which is about 36,000 RPM, you plug a Dremel tool into this and you can slow it down and it makes it much easier to control. You can do a lot more with it. And anything that has a motor in it, you can use it for a fan, you can use it for virtually anything within limits. But this is more than heavy duty enough for the shaver. And as I said, you can just set your speed and from then on, the shaver will run at that speed. And if you want to turn it up, you can. If you want to turn it down, you can. So just a really simple device. It's inexpensive. Home Depot, they're, I don't know, 10 bucks or so. And it gives you an instant speed control for your shaver. You could just mount it on the shaver, I suppose, if you wanted to. But it works, and you can use it for lots of applications. But like I said, if you're going to be recording Edison cylinders, one of these shavers is absolutely imperative. You have to have one. And with this little stand, you got a full-size shaver in a little tiny space. So just a quick video on adjusting the speed on your cylinder shaver. As always, if you have any questions or comments, feel free to drop me an email, thevictrolaguy@gmail.com. Tomorrow I'll probably get this finished, and I'll do a video on the final version of the new stand once it's all screwed together, glued together, and ready to go. I may even paint it. We'll see. Anyway, if you have any questions, feel free to drop me an email, thevictrolaguy@gmail.com. And as always, thanks for watching.